morning and welcome to our Safety Town graduation class of 2016. If everyone can please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Do we have our kids ready?
Please remain standing for the singing of our national anthem.
That's something new this year that we haven't had in the past, the singing of our national anthem. Pretty good. I want to welcome everyone and thank you parents and friends and community support for making today possible. Before I begin, I want to reflect on the many thoughts that have come to me this past week. As a teacher of middle school from September through June, I sometimes forget where it all began, and I'm left with a few burning questions. When did we stop playing on the playground? How did riding our bikes cease to be the highlights of our day? Why do we spend our lives chasing the next milestone and forget to live in the moment we are in? Hanging out with an energetic, happy, and curious group of kindergartners will bring out the question of why do we have to grow up? At 5 years old, life is wonder, exploration, and joy. This year's group is a testament to the power of innocence. Officer Mike and I have spent much of the week in awe of the potential these children hold. Our Safety Town counselors included, we think we have many future educators in our ranks. We see future CEOs, actors, artists, comedians, philosophers, and possibly politicians in our kids. They question, create, joke, think, and perform. Their world is fresh and new. Before you, the future of your kids is great, and their optimism is a lesson we can all learn from. I thank you as parents and community leaders for supporting the promise of these very special young minds. I would be remiss if I didn't thank those that are the backbone of this program. Our counselors work tirelessly each day and leave not just very tired, but also rewarded. They volunteer a week of summer because they hold Safety Town so close to their hearts. And for this, I thank them from the bottom of my heart. Please give them a round of applause. We also cannot forget the friend and hero in our midst, Officer Mike. He is so dedicated to the future of our youth. Thank you, Officer Mike, for being our friend and for your service to Safety Town and Ewing Township. We have to recognize many people in our community that have also helped make this possible with the Board of Education and the Kiwanis Club. So I'm going to welcome Bruce White, member of the UA Kiwanis, to come up and speak for a moment.
Thank you, Marcy. And thank you, Marcy and Officer Mike, for all your work. Unfortunately, our president, Jerry Spencer, could not be here this morning, so yet I would step in for him. Just a little bit, Marcy talked about starting Safety Town. Actually, we began planning this in December of last year, and the UA Board of Education has done a great deal to support this. And there's a person in the audience this evening, or excuse me, this afternoon or morning, who's done untiring work for the last 5 or 6 years to make this program go. She's the secretary to the business administrator, Debbie Wilson. Please raise your hand. Debbie is a very, very vital part of the program. And the UA Kiwanis Clubs, we do have two members here this morning, Joe Schmelz. Joe, if you raise your hand, and Mark Weatherby, also here this evening. Safety Town began about 35 years ago with an idea to come out of Mars. So some of our Safety Towners today are grandchildren of some of our first Safety Towners. I think they might be getting a little gray. I'm not sure, but it's great to see the grandparents. Then we have the parents, and now we have the grandchildren. And many times, these people come back. Marcy mentioned it. I don't think we can say enough about the efforts of the Ewing High School and the Fisher Middle School counselors who've given up their time. We've got Josh over here that's been doing this for 12 years, getting time in the summer. Thank you, Josh, for all of your work. We have many of our counselors who have done an admirable job, and I've been able to visit with them, are in their 4th, 5th, 6th year. And they make this program go. We just provide the support. So on behalf of you and Kiwanis Club, thank you for your support. This is our 35th year of Safety Town in the community. Thank you. Dennis Middleton, the Board Secretary for the Ewing Township Public Schools. Dennis.
Good morning, everybody. First, I just want to say thank you for letting me be here. They frequently do not let me out of my office, so it's nice to be here around kids and people and not just, you know, adding numbers up in a calculator. So on behalf of the administrative team, the Ewing Public Schools, it's a pleasure to welcome you to Safety Town Class of 2016 graduation. Thank you very much for joining us. I'd like to extend my thanks to the Ewing Kiwanis Club for sponsoring Safety Town, and I would also like to thank the Ewing Police Department for their fine staff and all the staff here for, you know, their help and support this year. For the parents in attendance, thank you for participating in this program. It's important to us. We are proud of the accomplishments of your children, and you should share in that pride today. Next year is going to be a big year for them, so there's a lot of changes. As a parent myself, I have a little one going into kindergarten, so this is a little bit of an interesting day for me. My oldest son is 9 today. I don't know how that happened so fast. To our graduates, all you guys, go forward and apply the lessons you've learned here to your young lives. Be positive, productive, responsible, and most importantly, safe citizens of the Ewing Township community. As you look with excitement to the start of kindergarten in September, reflect upon your Safety Town education and be prepared to be a leader in safety and citizenship as you begin your academic careers. So good luck next year, guys. We look forward to seeing you in September, all right?
We'd also like to welcome Officer Mike to the podium. I think he probably has a couple things to say.
I prepared about 9 pages last night, so bear with me here. I'm just kidding. Good morning, Safety Town class, counselors, parents, friends, and distinguished guests. On behalf of Chief Semler and the entire police department, I would like to welcome you guys here today. I can honestly say I have the best job in the world 1 week a year. It's an honor to be given the opportunity to work with such great people like Marcy and all the young counselors here at Safety Town. I would also like to thank the Kiwanis for spending countless hours donating their times and talents to bring such a great event and program to our little people here. Thank you, Kiwanis. Yesterday, our counselors and I talked about the whys in our lives. Our little people are the whys in our lives, this week, today, and this past week. Words cannot express the many thanks I give to you, the parents and families, for taking the time to get involved at such a young age in our little people's lives. Many of you, please take these memories today and from this week and cherish them for the rest of your life. Be well, be safe, and please remember that police officers are all your friends. Thank you.
We'd like to recap some of the highlights of our week, places we've gone, people we've met, and songs that we've learned. Probably you've learned them as well, hopefully. We began on Monday with our introduction to Safety Town, and we've learned a couple of songs about safety that we want to share with you today. So we're going to have all the kids come around to their spot on the floor. Good job. Find your spots. Before we begin, are your cameras ready? Okay. Somebody phone staring at us right now. The first song we learned was Red Light. Boys and girls, are you ready?
Yes.
All right, look out at the audience. Look at Mom and Dad. Are you ready? Okay. Look at Ashley and Melanie.
Start over. Ready?
Are you ready?
Take two. Wow, very impressive. I bet Mom and Dad could have sung that with you right now. On Monday, we also met a retired Amtrak police officer. Officer Harry Barnes came to visit with us, do some magic, and teach us about train safety. Officer Barnes comes every year as a volunteer just to give back to the community he so believes in. And on Monday, we also learned choo-choo goes the train.
Very
preparation for our trips that we took to the firehouse and the police station, we learned about seatbelt safety. And I understand a lot of them are reminding everybody in the cars as well for their seatbelts. That's right. Are we ready for seatbelt safety?
Yeah.
Okay. On Wednesday, we traveled to the Prospect Heights Firehouse, where we were met with some of our bravest members of our community. They taught us fire safety, stop, drop, and roll. We were able to squirt the fire hose. Very exciting day. And after that, as we came back to school, we also learned about water safety. It's summertime. These are good lessons for all of us to be reminded of. And we learned splish splash.
Splish splash in the water. I stay all around. I stay in the shallow part. But if you touch the ground. Splish splash in the water. Let me get you wet. I'm careful not to hit our fish.
On Thursday, Officer Mike took us to the Ewing Township Police Department, where we met one of the police dogs. We had also met one earlier in the week. We talked about how police officers are our friends, and we learned about the dangers of strangers and how to keep ourselves safe. Is everyone ready for our next song? Hey, stranger danger. This week, some of us took our very first bus rides, and we all remember the song we all learned as kids, The Wheels on the Bus. We are now going to head back to our building so that we can do our presentation of diplomas and medals. I also want to mention that this graduation will be aired on the Ewing Public Channel in a couple of weeks.
You may have a blank panel.
Thank you. going to welcome Melanie Post to the podium, who will be announcing our names. Melanie has been a counselor in Safety Town for like 20 years. About 20 years. She is a future educator. She is just finished her freshman year at the College of New Jersey. I had the privilege of working with Melanie in my classroom the entire school year last, and I think that the future of the program is with our counselors when I retire. Counselors Cole and Kate led our post office. Alejandra Anderson. Miguel Gonzalez. John Trader. Kaylee Tooley. Counselors Rana and Kat led the town hall. William Chabowdy. Jordan Williams. Myself, Trevor, and Sarah led the police station. Nick Klein. Jordan Durval. Silris Teray. Jaden Weeks. Sam and John led the firehouse. Olivia Carroll. Joseph DeMemo. Brielle Lawrence. Thomas Ordini. Oliver Valentino. Ashley and Nick led our general store. Jake Bush. Elliot Deathridge. Leah Greaves. Tanner Hertzstein.
Samantha Johnson. Becky Alexa and Mia led our school. Seda Allen. Amelia Ferreira. Gabriel Giancarli. Luciana Perros. Alyssa and Evan led our hospital. Anderson Hughes. Ava McNally. Jeremy Morial. Richard Ricketts Jr. Dallas Wilberton. Olivia Princess led our airport. Christopher Kellyman Jr. Timothy Chapman. Ryan Dorval. Jada and Michael led our bank. Colton Bush. And Sabila Kohima. Caitlin Peel. Nora Velez.
Let's give all the kids a round of applause. We want to conclude by thanking everyone for this week, giving us the privilege of teaching and growing with your kids. I hope that these lessons stay with them forever. Keep singing the songs, always wear your seatbelt, no texting and driving. What we're going to show you now is our display of pedestrians and motorists. This was the highlight of every moment of every day. First question when we walked in each day was, when are we going to ride bikes? So we are going to show you how we ride bikes. And we're going to take half at a time. Let's do 1 through 5. Groups 1 through 5, can you walk along to the garage to get your bike? Groups 6 through 9 will be our pedestrians. I'd also like to mention that we have sign-ups outside on the table. If you would like a copy of the slideshow that we presented at the beginning of our graduation.
Yeah,
find a bike. If you've been on a bike, you need to find a sidewalk.
Thank you.
Counselors, let's get our kids back to our groups in case parents want to take a photo op. Parents, once we get them back to their buildings, you can come down and take a picture.
We're going to the councilors.